When we look at this problem, the first thing I'm doing, honestly, I'm ignoring this part. I'm looking just at this piece, which means distribution. We've seen things like this before. What number are we distributing, ladies and gentlemen?
-2x.
So I'm going to circle that -2. That's what's getting distributed. So far, so good?
Yep.
We're ignoring this whole part. Mm-hmm. What's my first term going to be?
-2x.
Perfect. What's my next term going to be?
+10.
I heard a couple different answers.
Plus 10.
Why 2?
Yeah, we're treating the signs with the numbers. So -2, -5, between like a -5, you're going to get the positive or +10. You guys agree that this part is the same as that part, right?
Right.
Yes.
We've already done stuff like that. That was 20 minutes ago. Now, we get to distribute this. Here's what I need you to do. Please watch carefully. This isn't going to make such a difference because that's a plus right now. However, that's a minus. This will make a huge difference. I always want you, this is why I had to do this, to circle the number in front of the parentheses with the sign, with it. So here we circled not 2, but -2. Here we're going to circle 4 with its sign, with that plus.
So we're going to start over.
Yeah. Okay. Same thing.
All right.
So we're circling that number with the sign. Are you clear on this?
Yes.
So it has to go with it. And we do the same exact thing. We have positive 4. Times positive 2x, how much is that?
8x.
So if we have positive 8x, please watch carefully, here's what you do. You never write two signs. You never write two signs. If you got positive 8, what
plus,
I put down here,
plus 8x.
You can put the plus 8x. So positive 8x translates to a plus 8x. Nod your head if you're with me on this, folks.
Yeah.
Good, okay, that's important, especially when we get to the negative. Okay, we'll do that next time, but I want to make sure you see this here. Then we'll do positive 4 times positive 2. How much did we get there?
8.
So we'll put plus 8. And is there anything else that we can do?
So we got like two like terms.
We do. I see a negative 2x and what else?
8.
That's going to give us
6x.
Good. Switching back to the addition rule. That's great. And then lastly, yeah, I see the positive 10, the positive 8. That's plus 18.
Can't do anything.
You're done. Yeah, you cannot combine those at all. Would you raise your hand and feel okay with what we talked about today?
Good, that's very good.
All right, so as I was saying, we're going to do an example. We're going to build these problems up until they look really complex, but we're realizing if we stick to the process of distribution with combined like terms, really they're a non-issue. So let's look at this problem. Realized about yesterday was that this is seriously like just three problems in one. If we know how to distribute and we know how to combine like terms, it's not even a big deal. So when we look at this problem, we're going to ignore the back half, we're going to look at the front half. Ladies and gentlemen, what number am I distributing from the first expression here?
-7.
So it's not just 7, I have to circle that number with the sign, we did that last time. So we'll circle this, we'll distribute it. It goes to both those terms in there. Can y'all tell me what's the first term I'm going to have?
-7x.
Perfect. And then we're learning also the shortcut to this. We're learning that if we take the signs with those terms and multiply them, the signs will take care of themselves. So we really just do this multiplication term by term. So I'm thinking about this as -7. I'm going to consider this one to be -4. I'm going to consider that sign to be part of that number. So when we multiply that, folks, how much am I going to get?
+28.
Yeah, why plus?
Because two negatives.
Okay. And we're not going to write 20. Explain the difference between this and what I should write. Why don't I just write that? Because that's positive 28, right?
Well, you won't have a sign there.
So
you know what to do.
Good, very good.
It's going to be one term.
Right, otherwise, yeah, it would be, right? It'd be completely different. Come on.
I have a question. Yesterday when we were doing problems, like, there was a negative right there where, like, say -4, but instead of, like, you put the negative on the bottom where the 20 is at, and then you multiply 8.
You mean from here to here, how this go from a minus to a plus? That's what we're talking about right now. It's a good question. What we're doing is we're considering these signs to go with the numbers. So if I'm looking at this one, yeah, it says -4. What we're doing is, because we can write this as x plus -4, Remember, we did that. We changed minuses to plus negatives. Because we can do that, we consider this minus to be a negative just for the time being. That allows you to do the term-by-term multiplication. The signs go with those numbers. They take care of themselves. So when we're doing this, how this is changing from a minus to a plus, let me ask you. Since we're distributing negative 7 and this is a negative 4, what's negative 7 times negative 4? That's why I'm writing that plus. So that makes that change that minus into a plus sign. Does that kind of answer your question? All right.
I know that, but I don't know. We did a thinking yesterday, and it had like the minus 4, the negative 4, but you brought it down and then just multiply.
Sure. I was showing you the long way to do that. I was showing you that there's two options for you. You can either do it this way, which is, it's pretty quick, right? We just multiply term by term. If you really want to, you could show negative 7 times x like that, minus negative 7 times 4. And you're going to see that if we do it this way, it is going to come with the same answer. We have the negative 7x. We have the minus negative 28. But then when we did this, guys on the right-hand side of the room, what was the minus and negative? What did that change to?
Plus.
So we'd write that plus. What we're doing, basically, is eliminating the need for this process by multiplying term by term. That's the idea there. Not too happy you guys are with me on that. Okay, good deal. All right, so good question. Thanks for that one. What's the next thing we do on the problem?
What are the next group?
Three
times x.
Sure, yeah. We also have to get rid of those parentheses, so that's great. It's just like three problems in one. We're distributing the first part. We're distributing the second part. After that, hey, combine some like terms. It'll be good. Now, can you tell me what I do before I start distributing? What do I want you to show me on this problem?
Plus 3.
Okay. So we're not just looking at the 3, we're looking at whatever sign's in front of that 3. In this case, it's the plus, so we're treating it like a positive 3. Okay, y'all tell me, what do we get when we distribute the first term, please?
3x.
What am I going to write?
Plus 3x.
Good. Okay, and it goes to both of them, so let's do the next one. What's the next thing I do?
Negative 3.
So we got negative 3, what are we going to write down?
Minus 3.
And we're done, right?
No.
Why not?
Combine like terms.
So let's have someone who hasn't spoken yet before today. What like terms do we have up here?
7x.
So when we do that, we circle them with those signs. That was a great job, you guys. And we're going to use those addition rules. So you have to be very good at changing back and forth between multiplication rules, which you're using for distribution, and now those addition rules, which we use for the combining like terms. So how many x's do we have? We have negative 7x and the plus 3x. That gives us?
Negative
4. Perfect. Cross these out as we go. Anything else?
20.
Yeah. Good, yeah, we know that anytime we have numbers up there, they're automatically like terms. What's that leave us with? Can we add those?
No.
Why not? Yeah, we got a variable, we got a number. We're done, that's as far as we can go. So this is kind of where we left off yesterday. What I'd like you to do, go ahead and do one on your own to really practice this. I'll be walking around. If you need help, let me know, because now is the time to get that before we go any further, okay? So let's try this one. So we're looking for parentheses first. Whatever we distribute, we distribute. We certainly remember with the sign, make sure it goes to both those terms inside there. After you've gotten rid of the parentheses by distribution, then we combine like terms. Thank you. Well, that's a good work so far. That's great. You know, I've had a couple questions as I circulated in the room. Why can't we solve for x in this problem? You guys should be able to answer that right now. Why can't we go any further on the negative 4x plus 25?
Because it's not an equation.
Okay, what
it's
makes...
not a variable.
Not the same variable.
Well, what makes something an equation?
It has an equal sign.
Those are the only things you can actually solve. So if you don't have an equal sign, we can't ever say how much x equals. We can't evaluate it, which means I can give you a number to plug in. But what we can't ever do is take this problem right here and say, oh, x equals 25 over 4. It doesn't make any sense to do that. We have this; it's not equal to anything. Does that make sense to you? So in case unless we have that equation, we're done with our manipulation at this point. All right, let's go ahead and let's try this problem out for us. What's the first thing we're going to do on our problem here?
Circle that.
Yeah, we do want to circle that. And you're going to see why in just a bit, why we circle this number. And then we distribute it. Okay, folks, we should get negative 9 times positive x. Hopefully you got negative 9x, did you? The next one we got to be rock solid on. This is one, the first part is where everyone's going to get that right. The second part is where those signs become an issue, and sometimes we have a little foul up there. So we got to be real sure. If we're going to multiply negative 9 times what we're going to consider to be negative 1, what are we going to get out of that?
Plus 9.
Perfect. Yeah, great. How many people got the plus 9? Good. That's really good. Okay. That's important. Well, we're done with the first part. Let's move to the second part. Of course, we'll circle our plus 4. We'll distribute that to both of our terms inside. First term, what's that give me?
Plus 12x.
Good, so we notice when we're saying positive, we're actually writing the plus. We're changing that to our plus 12x. And then lastly, we'll do our positive 4 times our negative 4 and get how much?
Negative 16.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
Why is it minus?
It's minus because when you multiply a positive times a negative, you're going to get the negative, right? And this is the whole idea of changing between a plus minus or a plus negative into a minus itself. So we're kind of going backwards of what we did with our subtraction rules a couple sections ago. That's the idea. So after we've distributed, that's when you check for any like terms. Do we have any like terms?
Negative 9x and positive 12x.
Sure, let's do that. If we combine them, use the addition rule, we get different signs, subtract, sign the bigger number, gives you
3x.
Perfect. And lastly, we'll have positive 9, negative 16, that gives me what?
Negative 7 minus
7. I'm done. Can't combine. I feel pretty good about this so far. Do you remember what would happen if I put just a negative in front of parentheses like this? Do you remember what that does?
The negative goes with...
What number's really out in front of that?
1.
Okay, so let's add some more stuff on this and see if this works out the same way. So how about that one? If you remember from last time, we said, yeah, that negative out front, what it really means is a negative 1 that we have to distribute across both those terms. And essentially, basically what it does, it just changes the sign inside the parentheses. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, is it going to change this sign?
No.
Why doesn't it change this sign?
It's in front of the parentheses.
Okay, so right here, we're just looking at this negative across the parentheses. These numbers, they're not going to change. So when we rewrite our problem, sure, we're...